Once, Louis IX asked his friend and biographer, the Sir T. John Bellay, "What is God?" John Bellay replied,
"Sir, it is that which is so good that there can be nothing better."
The king said,
"Now tell me, would you rather be a leper or commit a mortal sin?"
The spectacle of the wretched lepers might well have prompted to ask such a question. John Bell answered in all frankness,
"I would rather commit 30 mortal sins than be a leper."
Louis protested him earnestly for making such a reply. Louis said,
"When a man dies, he is healed of leprosy in his body. But when a man who has committed a mortal sin dies, he cannot know of a punishment. Wherefore he must stand in great fear, lest that leprosy of sin last as long as God is in paradise."
Everything King Louis IX did was for the glory of God and for the good of all his people. St. Louis was a patron of architecture. He built St. Chapel in Paris as a home for Jesus' crown of thorns. But more important than any building was the work Louis did for the poor. He was renowned for his charity. Louis, a follower of St. Francis of Assisi, was known for his ardent piety, penance, and holiness. Beggars were fed from his table. He ate their leavings, washed their feet, ministered to the wants of the leper, and daily fed over 100 poor. Such acts of charity, coupled with Louis' devout religious practices, gave rise to this legend that he joined the Third Order of St. Francis. His personal interest in the poor led to the founding of numerous charitable institutions, including orphanages, libraries, and hospitals for the people of France. One hospital for blind people near in Paris included a chapel, so the 300 blind men who stayed there could attend worship services. A hostel outside Paris, near home to a large group of women who had been driven by poverty to prostitution. Louis called it the House of the Daughters of God. He had a great love for the church. He was merciful even to rebels. When he was urged to put to death a prince who had followed his father in rebellion, he refused, saying,
"A son cannot refuse to obey his father."
Thus, in Louis IX of France, were united the qualities of a just king, a fearless warrior, a good Christian, and a saint. This Louis IX, known as Saint Louis, was born at Poissy, France, to King Louis VIII, King of France, and Blanche of Castile on 25th April 1214. After the death of his father, Louis was crowned at the age of 12 in the year 1226, although his mother Blanche ruled the kingdom until he reached maturity. Much of his virtue is attributed to his mother's care, for the queen devoted herself to her children's education. In fact, his younger sister Isabel is also recognized as a saint by the Franciscan order. Young Louis was instructed in the arts of war and government and all other kingly accomplishments. But Blanche's primary concern was to implant in him a deep regard and awe for everything related to religion. Often, she used to say to him,
"I love you, my dear son, as much as a mother can love her child. But I would rather see you dead at my feet than that you should commit a mortal sin.
On 27th May 1234, Louis married Margaret of Provence. The new queen's religious devotion made her a well-suited partner for the king. Louis has 11 children, out of which 2 died during infancy. Louis's actions were inspired by Christian values and Catholic devotion. Louis loved sermons, heard 2 masses daily. He decided to punish blasphemy, gambling, and interest-bearing loans. Louis simplified court administration and established fair laws and changed the tax system. Louis wrote out his ideas of government in a set of precepts which he gave to his son Philip. They say, in essence,
love God, do justice, and serve the poor.
Because justice reigned in France, peace followed. According to his vow made after a serious illness and obtaining a miraculous cure, Louis took an active part in the 7th and 8th Crusade, both of which were failures. In 1248, he led an army to Cyprus, and his Arab captors were quick to recognize in him a mixture of military valor and personal holiness, and were accustomed to kneel when speaking to him. He and his handful of surviving companions were released with the payment of a large ransom. In 1270, he joined another crusade which landed in Tunis, where he immediately caught typhoid fever and died on 25th August when he was 56. Throughout his kingdom, people mourned his death. His holiness had been a blessing to them. Even when his bones were transported back to his tomb at Saint Denis from Tunis, healing miracles were reported. Without awaiting the judgment of the Roman Catholic Church, the people considered Louis IX to be a saint and prayed at his tomb. Numerous miracles were witnessed, especially at his tomb, and people who had benefited from Louis's miracles gave testimony of their experiences. Marotte's parents carried her to Louis's tomb, and it was not until they placed the child's mouth on the tomb that she was cured and began to speak. Jehene recovered her hearing and speech only when she placed her head down on the tomb. Discarding many reported miracles, still 65 proven miracles were documented for his canonization. Thus, King Louis became Saint Louis when he was canonized by Pope Boniface VIII in 1297, 27 years after his death. Louis IX is often considered the model of the ideal Christian king. The Congregation of the Sisters of St. Louis is a Roman Catholic religious order founded in 1842 and named in his honor. The title confessor accredited to him would be justified from his words to his son Philip, who succeeded him to the throne.
Confess thyself often, and choose for thy confessor a right worthy man, who knows how to teach you what to do and what not to do.
As the parishioners of St. Louis Church Dicer, not only he is a patron saint for us, also his life is such a unique example for us as Catholics. He was a married lay Catholic, while a vast many of our beloved saints were religious or virgins. St. Louis left us with such a beautiful and much needed reminder that holiness is completely attainable regardless of our circumstances, vocation, or place in society. to the lame, blind and crippled who sought healing, the words uttered was,
"We have a good saint in our church at St. Denis. Carry a child to the tomb of St. Louis so that our Lord will see him delivered by his prayers."
May the intercessions of St. Louis bless us.